Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Friends, in this video, we'll discuss about conical pendulum. So let us start with conical pendulum. Hello students, let us start with conical pendulum and we'll define what is a conical pendulum, then derive the expression for the time period of a conical pendulum. So let us start with a conical pendulum. Before we know about that conical pendulum, we must know what is a simple pendulum. A simple pendulum is one which has a string which is straight and a bob, that is a heavy spherical mass, is attached to one end and the other end is fixed. And this is known as simple pendulum, and this bob is displaced slightly on one side and then released. Then this will move to and fro like that. This is how simple pendulum oscillates. So this is a simple pendulum. And what is a conical pendulum? A simple pendulum, and it is rolled in a horizontal circle. So when the simple pendulum is rolled in a horizontal circle, it creates a cone about the point of suspension. It creates a cone. This is therefore called as conical pendulum, because the circular motion of the bob projects cone at the point of suspension. So a simple pendulum rolled in a horizontal circle is called as conical pendulum. Now we will find the expression for the time period of conical pendulum. Now this is the diagram. The bob is suppose that it is moving in anti-clockwise sense like this in a horizontal path, and it projects a cone at this, and suppose this angle is theta. This angle is theta, that is half cone angle. Now the bob is in a circular path of certain radius. I call this radius as R. So this is the center. Suppose this is O, this point is suppose A, and this point is suppose B. So when the bob is here or here or at any position on the circumference, the distance of the bob from this point is same, because it is moving, because this is the same thread which is rotating, and this end of the thread contains the bob. So therefore the distance will remain same even if this point goes along the circumference, because the distance will remain same. So you have to imagine the diagram that it is not that when it is here this distance is more, or when it is here this distance is less than this distance. You have to imagine that it is the 3D diagram, it is not 2D. That is clear. So this distance is R. What is this distance? The string that is there, the string of the pendulum. This string has a length suppose L, and this distance B and O, this is what is that distance? If you look at this cone, then this distance is the vertical height from the point of suspension to the center of the circle. This distance is this distance, and this is the string, and this is the radius. So this creates a 90 degree over here. So this is a right angle triangle. So just let me write down those things that are written. L stands for the length of the string. R stands for, that is AB here. R is nothing but the radius. Circle in which it is moving. This is your OA. H is this one, height. Height of cone, which is BO. Now we will resolve the forces acting. We know that the bob is in circular motion, and for circular motion, centripetal force is required. Who provides centripetal force? The centripetal force is provided by the tension in the string is in this direction. This is the tension in the string, capital T. The weight of the bob, which is acting downward, is M into G, that is the weight. And apart from these two forces, there are no other forces acting in the bob. So the bob is subjected to two forces. T stands for the tension in the string, and MG stands for the weight. Now, because the bob is in a circular path, so centripetal force is needed. And who provides the centripetal force? That we already discussed. It is the net force towards the center. This is the center, net force. Mg is vertical and 90 degree with this line. So always the weight will be 90 degree with the radius, because this is just the perpendicular to this distance. So therefore, this force has no component along this direction. So only this tension has to be resolved. Now, because this is directed in this towards the point of suspension, what is its contribution towards the center? So I will resolve this into two components. One in along this direction. Suppose this is y direction, and another along x direction, in this direction. To resolve this, I must know the angle, whether this angle or that angle. You can see that this line and these lines are parallel. These are the opposite angles. This angle is theta, then this angle must be theta. Because in this situation, if this angle is theta, then this angle will also be theta. Now, if this is T, T is tension here, then this component which contains theta is cos theta. So this will be T cos theta. And this one will be T sine theta. This is T sine theta. Now, we have successfully resolved those tensions in vertical and horizontal directions. So, the T cos theta, so what is happening is, this is a bob, T cos theta is there, and Mg is downward. Mg is downward, and toward the center, I have T sine theta. So this will balance this, and this provides the centripetal force. This is the situation. Okay. Now, this T cos theta balances the weight Mg. Equation one. T sine theta is equal to the centripetal force, that is mb square by r. These are the two equations we got. Because this is the only force toward the center, so therefore it provides the centripetal force, mb square by r. Now, if I divide the equation 2 by equation 1, dividing these two equations, what I will get? I will get this by this. So it is t sine theta over t cos theta, and this will be mv square divided by r divided by mg. This implies t will cancel out. This t will cancel out, and here m will cancel out. Sin theta over cos theta is tan theta, and this is v square. This r is down, so it is v square upon rg. Now v square upon rg, so we'll though we are going to find the expression for the time period, we can find the velocity for x to find, because it is moving at the constant velocity that we are supposed to assume. That v equals to rg tan theta under root. This is the formula for velocity of ball in a conical pendulum. This is the expression. If we are asked to find what is the angular velocity, then in a circular motion, the angular velocity and v are related. Then v equals to omega r, because we know that in circular motion v equals to omega r. So substituting the value of v is omega r over here, I'll get r g tan theta under root. If I want this omega, if I have to find omega, then this r will come down, and inside it will be square. So it is g tan theta over r. This is the formula for angular velocity. Obviously, this is a linear velocity, and this is the angular velocity of ball. We are interested in the time period and omega, because we know that omega is 2 pi over time period. This is the angle traced in this much of time. This is a displacement, angular displacement over time t. So therefore, if I substitute this value here, I will get 2 pi over t is z tan theta over r. From here I write t equals to then 2 pi, and this will go to that side, and I'll have t equals to 2 pi r over g tan theta under root. T equals 2 pi under root r over g tan theta. R is there, and this is one expression for the time period of conical pendulum. If we know the value of r and theta, this is the expression if r and theta are given in the question. If it is not given, if it is given length of the string, then we have to express those things in terms of that. How it is done? Now, if we look at the string and the radius, and this is the vertical height. This was our O, and this was our A and B. This angle was theta. This angle is 90. This is the length of the string L. If this is L and this is theta, this is L cos theta, L cos of theta, and this one is L sine of theta. That means this radius equals to L sine theta, and this height is equal to L cos theta. That we can substitute when we need. Suppose the question R is not given, L is given, then we have to replace R by L, R by L sine theta. So, we can change the answer. So, in place of R, I write L sine theta. Okay, let me repeat that, because I have written that. I'll repeat, r becomes L sine theta divided by g tan theta, tan theta, write sine theta over cos theta under root. Now this sine theta will cancel out, and this is become 2 pi L cos theta over G. This is the time period of conical pendulum in terms of L and theta. That means if the half cone angle is given and length of the string is given, then we can find the time period of conical pendulum using this expression. Suppose that it is given in terms of height is directly given, height of the cone is given, then what will happen? We know that this L cos theta here is H. This L cos theta is replaced by H. So then we'll have the expression that T equals to 2 pi H over G. This is the formula you are using when height is given, nothing else is required. Only when height is given, you can directly write 2 pi under root H upon G. So these are the expressions. Most commonly used expression is this one. This is most commonly used expression. This is very important, so let me just write that. Time period of conical pendulum mostly used is L cos theta, because the length of the string is always given. This is the final expression for the time period of conical pendulum. So this is the okay, so thank you for watching this video. This is about the time period of conical pendulum. Then in the next video, we'll discuss something else, how to find the tensions. Okay, thank you.